Hello, my name is Laxman Swagati and I'm from Nepal, from the eastern part of Nepal. And I came here in Doha. I have shifted from Doha in 2014, November. So I came and I'm started working as a driver here.
Smash, smash, crack, bush, whack. Tie another one to the racks, baby. Hey, hey, kid, rock and roll. Nobody tells you where to go, baby. What if I ride? What if you walk? What if you rock around the clock? Tick, tock, tick, tock. What if you? Listen, you mentioned earlier that time is very important to you as a limousine driver.
Yeah, it's very important as a limousine driver because we have, you know, we have to walk according to the time. We should not be late even for 5 minutes also, because if you get late for 5 minutes for the clients, then they will be late in their work, or they will be late for their wish goals.
So,
and even for 5 minutes, if you get late, then we might get stuck in a traffic. So that 5 minutes late means we are going to be late for more than 10 to 15 minutes because of traffic and so on.
So you have to be very organized when it comes to pickups and drop-offs. Because for you especially, you sometimes have to pick someone up at a certain time, but then equally you have another pickup, like maybe an hour later.
If I pick a client, one client in a timing, then I can pick the another same time. But if I pick up first client late, then if I be a delay enough to pick a first client, then automatically I'll be late for the end of the run.
Exactly. So and quite difficult. And also it's quite, traffic here is very unpredictable and quite dangerous.
Yeah, traffic is very bad, yeah.
Yeah. So what happens if, would the client let you off if, so, like, if you called them and said the traffic's very bad because of a crash, would the clients understand?
Now, some they will understand, but some of them they will say it's not my problem because I have informed you already before so and so hour.
Okay.
You have to be on time.
All right.
Because of, but sometimes we really get stuck in traffic, and because of that we might get late 10 to 15 minutes to pick the clients. So it's very difficult.
Have you yourself ever been in a crash?
Yeah, I have been in a crash just before, 3 days ago.
Oh, okay.
And it's luckily I was saved there.
Yeah, you, no, I could see no physical injuries,
yeah,
so you
no
seem fine.
Injuries at all. Luckily I was saved, but my car is quite damaged.
Yeah. How many years in Nepal were you driving for before you came to Doha?
Actually, I was not a driver in Nepal. So this is my first experience that...
So when you moved to, when you moved to Doha...
I joined a school, driving schools, and I got a license. Luckily, I got a license and I started driving here. But when I was in Nepal, I was not a driver. I was just, you know...
But you knew you were coming here to drive.
Yeah, yeah. I knew I was coming here to drive.
Why did you come out here?
Because of, you know, like every problem is in, that is financial problems.
Financial problems, yeah.
Financial problems. Because working in Nepal is not sufficient for me,
okay,
as well as to feed my families, as well as to for any other purposes. So when I came here, it is quite better.
Yeah, you said that you were a student.
Yeah, I was not a student. I was a teacher in the primary schools.
Okay, well, what did you teach?
I used to teach maths and science.
Wow, that's impressive. But yeah.
Hello, yes, is the car is not there?
So you said you were a teacher of maths and science.
Yeah, maths and science.
So what, does it pay, is it better financially here to be a limousine driver than it is to be a teacher in Nepal?
Yeah, it's a limousine driver will get a quite more money because the rate is also different here. That's why the we'll get quite more. It's quite good.
Yeah,
it's comparing to Nepal's funding.
I can understand. Yeah. So, do you see the rest of your life being here in Doha?
No, I'm not planning so to live here more years.
More years.
I'm just planning to live here just like 4-5 years, and after that, I'm going back to Nepal. Just I think within 4-5 years, I can earn a little bit more.
Yeah.
So that I can go back to Nepal. I can lead a more happy life over there.
Yeah. That's good.
I'm thinking so. But I think I'll be here till 2022. I think
2022.
When the World Cup opens.
When the World Cup. Stay for the World Cup.
I'll see a World Cup. Yeah.
So you're saying you want to go back to Nepal after 5 years. Mm-hmm. What will you do when you get back to Nepal? Go back to teaching or?
I think now teaching, I think it won't be possible.
Yeah.
So I'll just driving.
Just driving back to Nepal as well?
Driving as well. Because I have accepted this as a profession now.
You've told me that you live with other limousine drivers.
Yeah.
How many people live in your house?
In my house, we live like 15 limousine drivers.
Wow, that's...
We live 15 limousine drivers in our house.
You have your own bedroom or do you have to share a bedroom with them?
Bedroom means in the... we have a one bedroom also and some bedrooms are sharing also.
Okay.
Like that.
Do you get your own bedroom?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you live in the same accommodation as your uncle and your...
accommodation is same. Even my uncle, my brothers, our accommodation is same. We live in the same accommodations.
Continue describing the driving here. Talk about it more. What's so dangerous about it?
It's dangerous about it's speed.
Speed.
Yeah, it's speed. Speed of vehicles is more dangerous because when we have a maximum speed and if we get sudden accident, then in that case to get leave is less. To get alive is very less chances.
Yeah. Also, every car here is a lot bigger.
Yeah.
Your car is not small, but it's compared to, for example, a Land Cruiser or a Pathfinder.
Yeah. In that case, it's also very difficult for us because we have to walk, we have to move according to the timing.
And yeah, you've also got a response. Do you feel that you have a responsibility to keep your passengers safe?
Yeah, we have more responsibility to keep our passengers very safe.
So you drive...
From pick up to drop off,
yeah.
We have to be very careful.
Exactly.
We have to be very careful and we have to take them in a safe way.
So spending so many hours in the car must be quite hard because...
It's very difficult to spend more hours in a car because, sometimes you have to spend more than 15 to 16 hours in a car per day. So it's very difficult. And when we will get out of the car, then it's very difficult. Our backbone will start paining and everything start paining. In that case, it's very difficult.
Do you ever not like being a driver?
I haven't thought that I'll be a driver in the future.
Mm.
I haven't thought.
Yeah.
My aim is not to be a driver.
Yeah.
My aim is something to be, but I haven't thought I'll be a driver like this.
Yeah.
Like a limousine driver, I'll be. I haven't thought.
But do you ever regret your decision coming to Doha?
No, I don't regret so because for what purposes I came here, that is quite I'm getting sure. So in that case, I'm not regretting. So I'm quite happy living here. Quite happy.
That's good.
Yeah.
Thank you.